Hey everyone, welcome to this week's Azure Infrastructure Update. It's the 27th of November. Those in the US, I hope you had a great Thanksgiving. And for me, now Thanksgiving has passed, I can now fully get in the getting ready for Christmas, which is my favorite time of the year. So Christmas He-Man is now being put out into my office. Because it was Thanksgiving week, there's almost no updates this week. So this will be super, super fast. I did have the week off. I had some vacation to burn, so I did quite a few new videos. I did a big deep dive video on verifiable credentials, looking at decentralized identity that uses decentralized identifiers, how all of that works. I think it's an hour and a half video, but this is the future of identity. So I don't often say things is a must watch, but this is a must watch. Definitely recommend everyone, no matter what part of computing or technology you're in, watch that. Last week I talked about translations and dubbing. After more research and what's the right thing to do, I'm actually going to focus on making the captions in English as perfect as possible and then use the YouTube auto-translate feature so you can put it into your native language. That seemed more useful than dubbing to a few specific languages. So I did a quick video just demonstrating that on the web and on the mobile platform. I then did a video all about the Azure hybrid benefit, taking advantage of existing licenses you may have in the cloud. And then as part of my virtual mentoring, my top three tips for using the whiteboard. On to what's actually new this week. Azure Bastion now has a shareable link feature. So Azure Bastion provides a managed jump box service that primarily we use by going to the Azure portal. And then through that, as part of my connection experience, I can say, hey, use this Azure Managed Bastion I have deployed. I can also use it through native tools, but primarily I use it through the portal. But that means as the user, well, I have to have access to the Azure portal. I need permissions to certain resources. So what this enables me to now have is through RDP or SSH, I can share a link. And by using that link, it will leverage the Azure Bastion and go to that target resource without the user ever having to go into the Azure portal and do anything. It doesn't include permissions, so they still have to actually enter credentials to log in and authenticate to that target Windows or Linux machine. But now, hey, I don't need any permissions in the portal itself. I just need to be able to authenticate to the target operating system. It's only for the standard SKU of Azure Bastion, but now it's in preview. You can go and try that out. And then the other new feature is cross-subscription virtual machine restore, again in preview. So ordinarily, when I have restore points, I can restore them within the same subscription that is hosting those restore points. So now what I can do, providing I have the right role-based access controls, i.e. I have the permission to restore, I can restore it cross-subscription. It has to be under the same Azure AD tenant, but now, hey, I can do it cross-subscription. So I could create a new VM from that restore point or just create new disks from the restore point and then create a VM from those disks. Obviously, I can't replace existing because I'm doing it to a different subscription from where the VM was. But hey, we now have this great cross-subscription VM restore experience. And that's it. I said there were two updates. There's your two updates. As always, until the next video, take care.